Atlantis has been history's greatest mystery. There have been hundreds of theories throughout time, placing the resting place of the lost continent at the Mediterranean, the Arctic, Central Asia, South America, San Leandro, Winnemucca, north of the Pecos, Lake Titicaca, San Fire.
The windmill.
Nice work, Gage. Now that we've dammed that river, we can get into the secret passage. After you. This mural might be depicting some form of religious ceremony. The basin at the top is filling up with water from the geyser. What's interesting to me is that pyramid object inside the water column. Either he's one of those...
Yes.
Opera... What...
That's not exactly a Casio, but it looks like some form of mechanism that tracks the passage of time. That must be what a moon meant by a clockwork device.
Brilliant work! Looks like your water clock repair correspondence classes finally paid off.
Excellent work, Gage. While you were gone, Dalton and Michelle discovered something remarkable about the first artifact.
We concentrated our efforts on the overlapping symbols covering the artifact. With a little luck, we found formulae beneath several layers of inscriptions.
And this is the remarkable part. The formulae details the physics necessary for time travel. The very same physics that powers our own jumpsuits.
So the secret of time travel was purposely hidden in our past? And Dr. Sinclair invents that same technology centuries later.
What is this thing? Quothalus have entered the Earth system?
Nothing has deterred them. They've ignored the Cerulean ambassador's plea for peace talks. The symbiotry appears powerless. It looks like it's all up to us.
I'll find the last artifact.
And you said you didn't have a green thumb.
Nice job, Gage. That's a statue of Buddha, the holy man responsible for creating the Buddhist religion. Before becoming a deity, Buddha was known as Siddhartha, a man from India who transcended worldly suffering, becoming a paragon of spiritual perfection.
What?
Gage, don't panic, but we may have stumbled into a Turkish... The inscription... I believe those deep the shrine.
Do I expect you to leave the steam tunnels?
No, Agent Blackwood. I expect you to die! You can thank phosphorescent yellow lichen for the romantic mood lighting in these tunnels. But from what I hear, all the fun's definitely in the red lichen district. With all this steam, it's no wonder the Khan has such smooth skin. I'm detecting a definite shift in temperature. You did it, Gage! I have a theory that might explain the extra heat. While we were exploring these tunnels, it's possible that we managed to open doors that lead to steam vents, which could have diverted more heat to this room. Or global warming started earlier than anyone ever suspected. The dangling cylindrical columns hanging from the ceiling are victory banners. They represent the victory of Buddhism over ignorance and death. That other banner represents the victory of the Boston Dob Dobs over the Nepal Red Yaks in the 44 series. Look, another Buddha statue. But that one is a different color. I wonder if there are any other colored statues around here. Maybe the ever-elusive Fuchsia Buddha? That tent seems out of place. If my history serves me, that yellow banner atop the tent bears a Mongolian symbol. And if history serves me further, the great horde of Genghis Khan was terrorizing Asia about this time. Well, there goes the neighborhood. Here, Swiss Miss grows only the finest hot chocolate beans. Looks like there's another inscription.